Welcome back to Oral Health and Medicine Separate Not Equal. Our topic for today will be focused on disparities in access to oral health care, with particular emphasis on social determinants of health. To begin, it's helpful to define social determinants of health. According to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, social determinants of health are conditions in the places where people live, learn, work, and play that affect a wide range of health and quality of life risks and outcomes. Due to these social determinants of health, there are particular racial, ethnic, and socioeconomic groups that have worsened oral health for a variety of reasons. Many of these groups are a part of the racial ethnic minority, are located in rural areas, are low income, and do not have health or dental insurance. Some live in communities that do not have access to fluoridated water, high quality oral health care services, or the ability to finance regular checkup appointments. In fact, one of the most prevalent chronic diseases are dental caries, which is tooth decay or cavities, and periodontal disease, which is inflammation of the soft and hard tissues surrounding the teeth, even though they are largely preventable. This stems from the fact that many people do not have access to or are unable to participate in regular preventative dental care. It has also been recognized that these oral diseases are closely associated with health conditions, including obesity and diabetes. The separate systems of oral health and medical care intensify these disparities in access to basic dental care in underserved and low-income areas. Since many commercial dental insurance plans have high co-insurance rates and annual maximum benefit limits, a large amount of oral health care spending is out of pocket. Additionally, traditional Medicare does not cover routine dental care unless the dental treatment is integral to other medical treatment. This statement is incorrect and continues to perpetuate the idea that oral health and systemic health should be treated separately. Under Medicaid, adult oral health care benefits are not required, which contributes to varied dental coverage across state lines. Many states only limit coverage to emergency services or specific populations such as pregnant women. When looking at some statistics, we see that children of color are less likely than white children to visit a dentist and receive preventative care, such as fluoride treatments or sealants. In fact, only 10% of Hispanic and Black children received preventative service in 2009, compared with 17% of white children. There are similar statistics for groups that are more likely to suffer from untreated tooth decay. As a result, there's a critical need for interventions at the local, state, and national levels to address accessibility to oral health and create affordable oral health care coverage for everyone.